It's estimated that more than 40 million people in the US suffer from anxiety disorders. So could something from ancient times be our modern day cure? Joining us is spiritual guide and the author of Spirit Hacking, Shamanic Keys to Reclaim Your Personal Power, Transform Yourself, and Light Up the World. Please welcome Shaman Durek back to the show.
Whoa, welcome back. Good to see you.
This whole concept of spirit hacking, what is it and how can it help those of us out there who are dealing with so much in modern life? Anxiety, the list goes on and on.
So spirit hacking is literally about connecting with yourself, connecting with people, and how you associate yourself in the world today. And the way it helps people is to really simplify things in their life. You know, a lot of times what happens is we get so bombarded by everything that's going on in our world, from our families, our children, to our, you know, our work situation, to everything. And spirit hacking is about being able to make those changes, really simple changes that have long-lasting results.
In your book, you talk about how people are people pleasers and codependent. Can you talk about that a little bit?
You know, in today's modern society, we've become very, you know, caught up in the idea that everyone has to make someone happy. So we go around making everyone happy and we forget about ourselves. And that's the biggest mistake we make, because when we forget about ourselves, we then create stress, we create anxiety. And when you're people-pleasing people, you have to understand that if you're not putting yourself first and you're not looking at how you're affecting the lives in your family and the people around you, because you're burnt out, you have no more energy, and then that's when you get agitated, you get frustrated, and you don't have any more energy to give. And so in that people-pleasing state, you're creating all kinds of health problems that can come down the line. And the thing is, you have to moderate yourself. You have to check in with yourself. You have to say, hey, you know what? Is this something that I really want to do? Or if I don't want to do it, then don't do it. Then the thing is when we become codependent in society, we begin to believe that everyone is going to fix everything for us, that they're going to figure it out. And in today's society, we are constantly being told that this is the problem, this is the problem, this is the problem. And all of these things that are the problem, we take no responsibility for. And taking an active responsibility in your life literally leads you to a long, healthy life with less stress.
How do we put ourselves first without ignoring others? How do we obviously have the ability and learn the ability to solve our own problems, but still be there for others? What is the secret sauce there? Because that's not easy.
Well, again, if you say that's not easy, then it doesn't become easy, right? The thing
is, that's easy.
There you go.
Tell me how it's
and
easy.
That's also a spirit.
Tell me how it's easy.
So the way it's easy is that you have more energy and more time for yourself by putting yourself first and not people pleasing. We were raised in a society that the moment you are coming to earth as a child, you're told all of these ideas about what it means to be right and what it means to be wrong, which is subjective to each person's family. So the idea of following someone else's right and wrong does not support you. So a lot of times people will do a lot of things to make people like them, because it's the whole culture of being liked. I mean, you look at like all of the social media, what is it about? Hearts being liked, yep. Like this, like you, you know, hearts. And it's all because human beings are constantly needing that accolade of, look, I'm a good person. I'm a good person. Look, I did this for you. I did that for you. But at the same time, you know, like I always say to people, like being good gets you an apple pie. Being truthful gets you the kingdom.
Wow.